Namaste students, now we are going to discuss about the topic stepwise thinking. You have already read about this topic. We are going to recollect this topic. Can we see your stepwise thinking? What do you mean by step? Step is a ladder. So if you want to reach the top of the ladder, means first what you will do? First, you need to start move from the step one, yes or no. So directly you can't able to reach there. Step by step only you can reach the top of the ladder. So when you start think step by step only, you can reach the top of the ladder. So each step have some activity to cross a level of that. So first level, that means first step, there is some activity to process. If you complete that activity, means then only you can move to the second level, that is second step. So first you need to finish the first step of your activity. So likewise, if you finish the step by step, then only you can reach the top of the ladder. See your first point. The process of completing one step and jumping on to the other is known as a stepwise thinking. The process of completing, the process what you're going to complete in the step one, if you complete that process in step one only, you can move to the second step. You can able to jump into the next step. That is called stepwise thinking. So you need to finish the first step of the activity, then only you can able to move to the second step of the activity. And after you finish the second step of the activity, you can move to the third step of the activity. So by seeing the process itself, you can able to understand it is a step by step process. So this is called stepwise thinking. Okay, so see the second point. Every activity has a sequence. So every activity, there is a sequence of step. There is a sequence of step that needs to be followed. So each step, there is an activity. So if you complete that process of activity only, you can move to the next step. So it will have some process, that too in a sequential order. If you finish the first activity only, first step activity only, you can move to the second, then third, then fourth. So like that, it will move sequentially. So this is called stepwise thinking. Once again, the process of completing one step and jump on to the other is known as a stepwise thinking. Every activity has a sequence of step that needs to be followed. So from this, what you have understood, stepwise thinking is a step-by-step process. If you complete the first step of the activity only, you can move to the next step of the activity. Okay, this is called stepwise thinking. See your steps to organize a picnic in the water park. There is some steps to organize a picnic in a water park. So I have some four steps is here. So take it as an example also. Now in our school, they are going to arrange some picnic for you. So for water park, think like that. So first, what they will do? First point, see there. Make an announcement about the picnic. They will make an announcement to the old school about that picnic. Yes or no? In the assembly hour or in the prayer hour or in the classrooms, they will make an announcement to you that I have a plan to go for the picnic. Like that, they will give an announcement. That is your first point, first step. Then second step, ask the interested students to give their name listed. So those who are interested to come to the picnic can come and give your names. That is your second step they will do. Those who are interested to come for the picnic, come and give your names. That is the second step. Next, book tickets. So after getting the name list, what they will do? They will book the tickets for them. Those who are interested to come to the picnic, they will book the tickets for them. That is the third step. Then fourth, after booking the ticket, travel to the water park. All of them will travel to the water park. So they will go for the picnic. So these are the step-by-step process. They are thinking in a stepwise manner. Okay? See here. Next. Examples for stepwise thinking. I have one simple example. By seeing this itself, I think you have able to recollect the topic. See here. How to draw an umbrella. First step. So I am drawing a J letter. A small J letter I was drawing. That is my first step. Second step, I am drawing a line on the top. That is my second step. Third step, I am drawing a half circle in the line. See the third step. Yes. Okay. Next, fourth step. Inside that half circle, I am drawing the lines. Then again, move to the fifth step. Again, I am drawing lines inside that half circle. So now, I got an umbrella. By drawing a step-by-step process, I got an umbrella. So this is also one type of stepwise thinking, to draw an umbrella. Okay. This is a simple example I have shown you now. Again, I will show another example. See here. How to draw an ice cream in a stepwise thinking. See here. This is also a simple thing. I have one cone. That is my first step. I have one cone. That's all. Second step. There is only one cone with me, but no ice cream inside. So I am drawing an ice cream. That is my second step. Then I need a cherry for that. Yes or no? If I kept cherries inside that ice cream, means it will be nice to see. So at the top of the ice cream, I am drawing one circle. That is my third step. Then, see the fourth step. The cone it is so simple. So, inside that cone, I am drawing small lines. And again, I am drawing another small lines. So, see the fifth step. It is totally, now it is looking like an ice cream. Yes or no? So, I have drawn our ice cream in step by step way. So this is also one of the examples, simple example for stepwise thinking. Okay, not only you want to put lines inside that cone, any design you can put. Okay, so it should look like an ice cream. So my in the fifth step, it is looking like an ice cream, yes or no? So now I have drawn an ice cream in stepwise thinking. Okay, in step by step process I have drawn an ice cream. So this is one example. Next, so I think you have understood what is a stepwise thinking. Step by step you need to do the activity. At last you will get a clear picture of your activity. Okay, so that is called step by step process. So this is my activity I have given for you. See the first one, draw the dog in stepwise thinking and arrange it in a stepwise sequence using that 553553. You're going to draw an dog step by step, that too in a sequential order. Sequential order, you need to draw the dog using this numbers. Okay, using alphabet, draw some image. So using what? Using J letter, I have drawn one image, no, umbrella. Like that, using any other alphabets, you're going to draw some image. That should be in a step by step process. Okay, using using numbers, draw some images. Using numbers you're going to draw, so that should also in a step by step. Then see the last question, fourth question, how to prepare a salad using vegetables and fruits. You're going to prepare a salad. It should be in a step by step process, and it may be in pictorial representation, image madri neenga draw panni adha show panna kuda okay, but it should be in a step by step process. Otherwise in a statement form, sentence formation la irundalum it's okay for me. Okay, next we can move to the next slide. See here, one activity I given here, find the stepwise sequence. I given some steps, you going to rearrange the steps. Already it was rearranged, you going to arrange it in a sequential order. Which should come first, which should come second, like that you going to arrange it and you going to say, this is my activity. So that's all. So I'll go through this video fully. Do this activity. So if you practice by doing this activity, you will get more ideas. Thank you, students.